The screen selector object allows the user to select from a list of screens. When they click on the screen selector object, a menu pops up so they can jump directly to any screen they want. Note that you can limit which screens appear in a list, and you can use function keys to navigate the list on non-touch screen panels. Let's see how to set this up. Before we get started, notice that we have four screens here on the left, labeled green, yellow, light green, and orange. To create a fifth screen, just click on a new screen button, give it a name, we'll make this the red screen, change the color to red, put any notes in you want. By the way, it doesn't have to be screen number 5. You can make this any screen you want within 999 screens. We'll leave it at 5 and say OK. So now we have 5 screens. Each one has a name of its background color. Double-click or drag the screen selector object onto the screen. The radio buttons allow you to determine the format of the list that the user sees. You can have just the screen number, just the screen name, or both the screen number and the screen name. We're going to use that in this example. Over here on the Screen tab is where you select which screens the user has access to. By default, all of the screens are selected. But let's say we only want them to have access to screens 1, 3, and 5. Just deselect the All box, highlight screens 2 and 4, and say Delete. That moves them over to this column of available screens. Well, let's see how this works. Say OK. Put your button wherever you want it on the screen. Let's put a copy of this screen selector button on every page so we can navigate around. I'll paste it on the green screen, the yellow screen, the light green screen, and the orange screen. Let's simulate that. Save the project. And up pops our simulator with our screen selector object. Now we have one of these on each screen so we can move around this simple project. If we click on our screen selector object, sure enough, up comes our menu with just the 3 choices. We can pick whichever screen you want to go to and head straight there. Note that you can also use the function keys. We can scroll up using F3, down with F4, and select a screen with F5. If you want to learn more about changing screens, check out the other videos on how to use screen change objects. Those allow you to create buttons to go directly to an individual screen, and also the video on how to control screens from a PLC if you want your PLC to be in charge of screen changes. Well, that's it for this video. Be sure to check out all the other videos in this series. And as always, please send us any topics you would like to see covered, or any other comments for that matter. We appreciate the feedback.